Let's give it a spin. There you go. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And now, if we assume that a human labeler would spend 10 seconds on each label, skilled human labeler might be able to do that quickly, then we have just saved 27 hours and 46 minutes. OccCANINE is a new tool to make research with historical occupations much easier. It's based on a language model called canine, which we have fine-tuned for the purpose with 14 million examples of HISCO codes. The result is a transformer-based model, which takes a language and an occupational description. For instance, it takes the language English and here's a farmer, and then outputs a probability of a specific HISCO code. In this video, we will briefly go over OccCANINE and its performance, and then we will introduce how to use it, and introduce how to use it very simply in more or less a one-line command line interface. This is the team behind this tool. All of us are researchers at the Department of Economics at the University of Southern Denmark. OccCANINE is trained on 14 million examples of occupational descriptions. We get all this data from various different research projects which were either publicly available or explicitly shared with us. And for this, we are immensely grateful. So there's a lot of data out there which describes people's occupation. Here we have some data from marriage certificates in England, and you can see just the variety of different descriptions that exists, and much of it is not very systematic. So the old solution is that you spent weeks, months, years manually reading these descriptions and categorized them. And as you have just seen, there are so many different ones. And just as a bit of a cautionary tale, here's a tale of occupations in Danish. In Danish, there are 17,865 different occupational descriptions in the Danish census that fits the description farm servant. You can be in service, you can be a servant girl, you can be a servant boy, you can be a servant woman, you can be a servant Carl. It's not simple to just search for a specific word and then just use that word. And then, of course, on top of that, you just have spelling mistakes in general, you also have negations, and you have different spelling conventions. Our solution is that we take a language model like this one. It takes as an input a language and a description. And then this is run through an advanced transformer model, which then outputs the HISCO codes. It's a fairly simple neural network based on the transformer architecture. It's a character level transformer model. That means that it reads the individual characters that we input. And this also means that it's fairly robust to typos, spelling mistakes, and the changing spelling conventions. The model that we have trained ends up working incredibly fast. We can get 10,000 HISCO codes in around 27 seconds. We can get 100,000 HISCO codes in around 5 minutes. And we can get around 1 million HISCO codes in 45 minutes. Now here's how well it works. This is the test data performance. So among the millions of observations of data, we took some of the data and left it aside so that the algorithm wouldn't see that in training at all. No matter how we measure, the tool works well. The accuracy is above 93%. The precision and recall is also in the high 90s. And the F1 score, which is a mix of precision and recall, is also incredibly high. It also works well across all the different languages for which we trained it. And even more than that, if we take a look at some data that was not seen at all, so these are entirely new data sources that we didn't even think about when we developed this model, it also works really well in those. So just before we look at this more specifically, we just want to encourage you to go and check out the paper. We list caveats in using it, and also generally make recommendations, and we document everything, of course. This notebook demonstrates the capabilities of the tool that we have developed. For any use at scale, we recommend taking a look at the GitHub repository, and in there you'll find other guides on how to get started, how to set up everything locally on your own system, and you will also find a natural starting point, for instance this predict HISCO script, which is just a very very simple script where you load some data and output some HISCO codes. Now, to get started, first of all, we need to download the GitHub repository locally, and we do this by running this command. It takes a while the first time, but it's only necessary to run this once. There we go. Next step is to install the library, which is included in this repository. We do that in this way. There you go. And then another library, which is not included by default in Colab, is this library here. So there you go. And then we are actually ready to get started. What we do is that we load the OccCANINE module from this historical occupations package that we just installed. And then we initialize the model with the class that we just loaded. This function here, send the downloads to the neural network from a web page called Hugging Face, and then it initiates everything with everything you need to know. Everything is wrapped up in this little object here. And if you have already downloaded this, so the first time you run it, it will download it. The next time, it doesn't need to download it again. There we go. And now we're actually just ready to predict some HISCO codes. Let's start with an example to see how well it works out of the box. So what we'll do here is that we will run model.predict, and then we will write up some occupational descriptions. Tailor of the finest suits, local boilermaker, trained fireman, and so on. And then we'll specify that we want to get a dictionary as an output. By default, you get a data frame, which is nice if you use this at scale, but for demonstration purposes, it's nice to get a dictionary as output. There you go. A tailor of the finest suits has the HISCO code 79190. The local boilermaker has the HISCO code 87350, he's a boilersmith, and similarly for the trains fireman. Now, for this, we didn't provide any language information, so I just defaulted to use an unknown language. So we can get even better results if we use language information. And OccCANINE is trained in English, Danish, Swedish, Dutch, Catalan, French, Norwegian, Icelandic, Portuguese, German, Spanish, Italian, and Greek. So we are able to get fairly highly accurate HISCO codes for all those languages. And it's incredibly simple, especially in the case where we have descriptions in only one case. We simply just provide it an argument, the language, and then what you'll see here is that we get the same HISCO codes, but now with a higher probability. And this is simply because now it knows that it is in English, and it's able to use that information to be more sure of its results. In some cases, of course, this will also make the difference between being able to infer the correct and versus the incorrect HISCO codes, and that for that reason, it's generally a good idea to use the language information. Now, of course, you might be concerned about how well it performs in many observations, because one thing is that we can predict three HISCO codes fairly quickly. I mean, if you know this stuff, then you can also do that pretty quickly. But where the real advantage is if you are somehow able to do a fast job than would otherwise be possible. And we are. So now we'll import pandas. Pandas will enable us to load a data frame to demonstrate performance in a lot of HISCO codes at once. Now the next step, of course, is that we have to load some data. And included in the repository is this toy data, which of course is useful to try out OccCANINE at scale and to play around with. Eventually, of course, you're probably not interested in toy data, but your own data, and it's probably also more interesting. But at least this can show how quickly it works, and also show you how you could go about and use our model here. So we read the data as a data frame, then we set the model to update us a bit more because we want to see what is going on while it's running. And then we specify that OCC1 is the column in this toy data which contains occupational descriptions, that the language is English, and that the threshold should be 0.22. So that is if it deems a HISCO code to be more than 0.22% likely, then it will say that that is the HISCO code or one of the HISCO codes of that specific occupational description. So let's give it a spin. There you you go. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And each of these are 256 observations. And so it has divided all of the 10,000 observations. This data contains 10,000 observations into chunks of 256. Now the prediction is done. Now it's just cleaning up the results for us. And there you go. It has produced HISCO codes for 10,000 observations in 26 seconds. And you can have a look at the data yourself. Here's the occupational description, and here's the HISCO code, and the description of the HISCO code, and the associated probability. And all of it looks pretty reasonable. Of course, we encourage you to actually take a look at the HISCO data and see whether it actually makes sense, at least for a few random observations as a sample. But even aside from that, we have changed the task, which would otherwise take 27 hours, into something that takes 27 seconds. And on top of that, like a few hours or maybe an afternoon of manually checking and validating that everything is as you want it to be. In some cases, you might want to fine-tune this. So it might be that you already have some HISCO-labeled data and you have some very specific setting in mind where it would actually make sense to use the HISCO-labeled data to improve performance a bit. It might also be that you are just in a setting where the performance is really important. For which reason you want to squeeze out a bit more of this method here. One way of doing that is that you can take your data and then you can run an algorithm and then you can check which ones are correct, and then you can use that as training data to save you some time. But you might also be in a world where you just have 10,000 observations already. In any case, the library here comes with a convenient way of doing that already. So let's just set it up. Of course, it should be here. Here we go. So this is the data, the toy data, and in the toy data we have an occupational description, and we have a HISCO code. And what we can now do is that we can fine tune the model to that HISCO data that we just gave that. So we do that quite simply with the .fine tune method. Then we tell us which data frame it should use. We have already specified that the labels can be found in HISCO 1. We will specify batch size, so that is how many observations should look at a time when training. We will also specify save name, so what name should our updated model be saved under, such that we can find it again, use it again in other settings. And then we might want some extra updates, because fine-tuning might take a while, so it's nice to know what is going on under the hood to be able to see whether it works as intended. So let's try it out. So fine-tuning started. Automatically, it takes 9,000 observations and uses them for training, and 1,000 observations to use for validation. Initially, it had an accuracy of around 90%, and now we see batch per batch, it improves slowly. Now, one batch, one epoch, that is seeing all the 9,000 observations once, takes around a minute and a half. Here we set it to train for 3 epochs. Of course, you can choose as you'd like, or as you see fit somehow. We'll return to this when it's done training in a few minutes. Great, so while I've been away, this has been running for a few minutes. This took a minute and a half, this took a minute and a half, and so did this. And in every single step, the validation loss improved and the best model version of the model was saved. The final performance, and this is in the 1,000 observations that were not used during training, is around 91% of this model, and seeing that we started off with 89%, this is a slight improvement, which might make a difference for the purposes of use that you might intend for this. Now, the result of this is that we now have a folder here called fine-tuned, and inside that folder we have this model here. And of course, it's already sort of already loaded into this this object here. But say that we start from scratch in another project, then we can also now load it using this command here that we also use to start off the project itself. So instead of just using the default model, we now use this fine-tuned model, and then we have to specify that this model is not a model which is found on Hugging Face. HF is for Hugging Face, and if it's false, then we'll assume that the model is a local one in the local directory and go and retrieve that. So we can then use this new model to try to predict the tailor of the finest suits, the local boilermaker, or the train's fireman as we did before. And once again, we get the same results, but now with significantly higher probability. That reflects that now it knows the settings even more. So now it's even more certain of the occupational descriptions and the associated HISCO codes with those.
Alongside the release of OccCANINE, we are releasing a number of command line interfaces for you to use to interact with the model. Let's take a look at the demo command line interface. If you pull from a Git repository, one of the files you will find is this demo/py. Let's try to see what happens if you execute this file. As you will see, this will make the model go through a number of default examples of occupational descriptions and provide the output that our model provides. You can also provide your own examples by using the -- examples argument. Here I provided three such examples, namely farmer, works on fishing boat, and retired soldier. Once again, we see that the model is able to come up with reasonable HISCO codes for all three of the occupational descriptions. However, you can go beyond simply providing examples. In this next demonstration, I've also specified the language using the -- language argument. Here, I specified Danish. Additionally, instead of providing an occupational description corresponding to just one occupation, I provided one corresponding to two different occupations. As you're able to see, our model will now output both of these occupational codes. In this next demonstration, I've mixed up my data such that now I have an English occupational code within my other examples. And as you can see, this leads to some confusion. The model now correctly gets that the second occupation is some other military ranks, but it's also thinking that something else is off and there's a missing or no title code. For purposes like this, instead of specifying a specific language, you can actually specify unknown. And this tells the model that you're not quite sure of the language used for all of your occupational descriptions. And doing so, you now see that the model correctly and confidently gets both the Danish and the English languages occupational codes correct. If you want to see all the arguments able to be accessed using the demo tool, you can provide the -h or -- help argument, and this will provide all of the settings you can use when interacting with the model using our demo command line interface. As a user of OccCANINE, what is probably the most useful tool is a command line interface for the predict method. The predict method takes as input a file of occupational descriptions and outputs a new file where the occupational descriptions have been transformed into HISCO codes. Let's have a look. In the command executed here, I take as input this file test data and write to a new file test data with predictions. As you can see, prediction is relatively fast. While this is going on, notice in the background that I have this input file open. To the left, you will see a column of occupational descriptions, and these are the ones the models use to base its predictions on. To the right, only included here for clarity and ease of comparison, is the actually HISCO codes associated with the occupational description. So transcribing these 10,000 different occupational descriptions took in the area of half a minute on my laptop. And saying that perhaps it takes 10 seconds for a human per label, this has now saved us in the area of 27 hours. If we look at the output of this method, this is a file you will see here. To the left, once again, we have the occupational description, but now we've added language information. To the right, we have the different HISCO codes that the model has predicted. Note that these are now the predictions and not the labels that you saw in the previous file. Additionally, at each prediction, the model includes a probability of how certain it is that it has got its prediction right, and we've also added a description. And additionally, if multiple HISCO codes might be present in a single occupation, those will also be included here. For example, in this row 22, we see that now both engineers, specialization unknown, and machinery fitter and machine assemblers have been deemed as appropriate HISCO codes for the occupational description, that is engineer, that the model got as its input.